Hi there. Let's learn how to record system audio and audio from microphone today. Knowing this, you can record your narration or system audio and record screen simultaneously, which is very common especially in creating video demonstrations. Let's start with recording system audio. Recording system audio comes with recording screen, so access the capturing mode first. On the start page of the application, click Record Video or Record Software Simulation. In the Record Video project dialog that appears, click the Audio button to enable audio recording. Then, click the drop-down arrow on the button and click Record System Audio. After that, to adjust the system audio volume, you can use the Adjust Volume tool on your computer. Whenever you don't want to use the feature, just deselect this option. Note that when you select to record system audio, all of the sounds on your computer including app notifications will be recorded. So, you should turn off notification sounds of unused apps to avoid any unwanted sound. Recording audio from microphone is used to record your voice while recording screen. In order to record audio from microphone, click the Audio button and select one from audio input devices detected. Then, change input audio volume by dragging this scale. In case you want to disable this feature, just select Do Not Record Microphone. One more thing that I want to remind you is that ActivePresenter allows testing sound before actually recording. This ensures your project has a proper sound level. You can learn how to do that in the video, Calibrating Audio Input. Now, click the record button and start capturing. After the recording, you'll have the project like this with the webcam video. If you record video demonstrations, recorded system audio file, audio from microphone file, and the captured video. In addition, when there is an audio input device selected, ActivePresenter allows you to record narration from the editor. First, in the timeline pane, click the Record Narration button. Then, the Record Narration button will appear to be disabled, and you can speak into the microphone. Click this button to pause and resume the recording. And click Stop to end the recording. After recording, ActivePresenter will save the recorded audio file in the current slide that you are working with. You can edit your recorded file as a normal audio file, which means you can take advantage of many audio editing tools, such as cut, change volume, etc., to enhance it. So, that's enough for recording system audio and audio from microphone in ActivePresenter. See you in other tutorial videos.